As we go through our day-to-day readiness checks, it is important to inspect our personal protective equipment. Part of your readiness check includes personally inspecting equipment before use and adhering to the proper refurbishment procedures at the end of your work shift. In this video, we will focus on the design, function, inspection, and helmet care. These helmets are designed to reduce the force of impact resulting from a blow to only the top of the head. The helmet shell and suspension system work together to absorb impact by stretching the suspension system and distorting the pliable hard shell. Protective helmets reduce the amount of force from an impact blow but cannot provide complete head protection from severe impact and penetration. Modifications to either the helmet shell or the suspension system may reduce the helmet performance. It is important to always follow the manufacturer's instructions and technical bulletins. Workers should never carry or wear anything between the helmet shell and the helmet suspension system. The suspension system needs to be oriented correctly. Be sure to check with the manufacturer's instructions or technical bulletins if reverse wearing of the helmet shell is determined to be necessary. Regardless of whether the helmet shell is oriented forward or backward, the suspension system needs to be oriented so the brow pad contacts the forehead and the nape device extends to the base of the skull. This video illustrates how to insert the suspension system into the helmet shell to be worn facing forward. Insert the suspension system inside of the helmet. Make sure the brow pad is forward. Start inserting the suspension keys into the suspension key slots. Work your way around the helmet one at a time and make sure each suspension key clicks into place. Make sure each suspension key is seated by pushing down on the straps. Clearance must be maintained between the shell and the suspension straps for the system to work properly. Next, attach the chin strap to the helmet. Hook the clip to the helmet and make sure there are no twists in the strap. You can tighten the strap around the back of the helmet when not in use, as you can see here. Every helmet is equipped with features to improve safety and ensure helmets meet required safety standards. The inside of the helmet shell has anti-glare material underneath the brim. There are two attachments on each side of the helmet for the chin strap. There are three loop fasteners, one at the back of the helmet and two on the sides toward the front of the helmet. The loop fasteners are essential for fastening a protective face-neck shroud. There are also labels inside the shell that contain important safety and manufacturer information. There are four retroreflective stripes on the outside of the helmet shell, two on each side. And there are three goggle and headlamp clips. All helmets are susceptible to damage from ultraviolet light, extreme temperatures, and chemicals, including gasoline and insect repellent. Helmets that are regularly exposed to sunlight, heat, cold, or chemicals may have an increased replacement frequency. The shell should be visually inspected routinely for dents, cracks, nicks, gouges, and any damage that might reduce protection. Check the shell for crazing. Thermoplastic shell material may be degrading if the shell becomes stiff, brittle, faded, or appears dull or chalky. A helmet should be replaced at the first sign of any of these conditions. Determine the date of manufacture. Helmets 10 years or older need to be replaced. Perform a physical inspection of the helmet shell by compressing the shell inwards from both sides about 1 inch with your hands and then release the pressure. The shell should return to its original shape quickly, exhibiting elasticity. Compare the elasticity with that of a new shell. If the shell being tested does not have as much elasticity as a new shell, or if the shell cracks, it should be replaced immediately. Inspect the suspension system closely for cracks, cut or frayed straps, torn headband or size adjustment slots, loss of pliability, or other signs of wear. Remove and replace any suspension that is damaged. The service life of the helmet can be extended by regular cleaning of the components. Clean the helmet shell with mild soap and warm water and rinse. Do not use solvents or abrasives. The suspension system is in constant contact with your skin when you are wearing the helmet. Maintain a clean suspension system. Remove and clean the suspension system with mild soap and warm water, and rinse. Consider following these simple steps when storing your helmet. Store the helmet in a cool, dark, dry place. Do not store the helmet near any chemicals. Avoid storing the helmet in direct sunlight, such as on the rear window rack of a vehicle. Remember that ultraviolet lights, chemicals, and extreme temperatures reduce the service life of the helmet. It is important to understand there are limitations to all personal protective equipment. Protective helmets reduce the amount of force from an impact blow, but cannot provide complete head protection from severe impact and penetration. Safety is the number one priority for all employees. You are responsible for ensuring your personal protective equipment is ready for the field. Be head smart and follow the helmet inspection and safety guidelines in this video to help enhance your helmet performance. The following accident reports on the Wildland Fire Lessons Learned Center website highlight the importance of head protection. This helmet inspection and safety video is in compliance with the following standards.